Since the 1980s, efforts to conserve the Sumatran rhinoceros has been an uphill task for conservationists in the region. Dato' Dr. Junaidi, the CEO of the Borneo Rhino Alliance in Sabah, knows it so well.
To run a conservation program, you need extreme passion. You need people who are willing to work 24 hours a day in an emergency without stop, do overtime on Sundays without necessarily any overtime pay, and that sort of thing. And one needs also a lot of discipline. Again, not to say that government people are not disciplined, but it's more is with very rare species, if you have to turn up at 8 in the morning, it needs to be 8 in the morning, not 10 past 8. I mean, you need to have that sort of almost military discipline sometimes.
The rhino sanctuary at the Tabin Wildlife Reserve now houses 3 Sumatran rhinos that were rescued over the past 3 years, with the latest in December last year. The setting up of the alliance is a big leap forward for rhino conservation in Malaysia.
Somehow one needs to forge an alliance between government, which of course has the main government owns the land and the forest. Rhinos legally are a responsibility of government, not of an NGO. So the government element needs to be there, plus an NGO, which in this case is Borneo Rhino Alliance, and also WF Malaysia is playing another role in rhino surveys in the case of Sabah. And where does the money come from? So the Borneo Rhino Sanctuary program is a program of the government of Sabah through the state wildlife department. Bora has a memorandum of understanding with Sabah Wildlife Department as the key agency to assist government in implementing the program. In fact, what I'd also say is the role of Yaz and Saim Darby in financing has been critical, not just important, but critical.
Conservation work at the sanctuary over the past 3 years was largely sponsored by fundings of 5 million ringgit from Yayasan Saim Darby, or Saim Darby Foundation. Bora managed to have this funding extended for another year with 6.4 million ringgit from the foundation. Bulk of the funding will be used in maintaining an optimum number of staff who will track down the rhinos and to set up tracks to monitor them.
It was clear to us that the program basically was worth continuing. Funding from government is largely infrastructure. I mean, frankly, government can put money into infrastructure, but not for all these other running staff and all these other unexpected costs.
With the additional 6.4 million ringgit, more traps can be set to capture and relocate rhinos to the sanctuary for breeding.
Rhino is one of the big 9. In addition to that, of course, the rhino is very critically endangered. It's on the critical endangered list. And indeed today, there are only 30 rhino left in the whole of Borneo. And between Borneo and Sumatra, it's only estimated to be 200 rhinos left. So there is a short period of time now where we can try to stop rhino, the Sumatran rhino, from becoming extinct. And that is why Yayasan Saim Darby has become involved. The funding has gone into a number of things in the Borneo Rhino Sanctuary in Tabin. A key area has been extending the facilities to house rhino, and presently we have 3 captured rhino at the sanctuary. We have improved the facilities, we've got a pen holding them, there are veterinary facilities there, stalls, etc. The sanctuary is part of the funding. The other key part has been staffing and facilities for staff, and also the payment of patrolling, because one of the core reasons why the rhinos are so highly endangered is poaching. And regular poaching patrols are going out to ensure that our captured rhinos are kept safe.
The government of Malaysia and Sabah has made a commitment to financing permanent rhino facilities. That's where the rhinos will be housed, looked after, and coaxed to breeding. That process has been disappointingly slow. That is just about started. You know, rhinos need to have the freedom to go out into their natural habitat, go and feed and wallow.
These interim facilities have taken up hundreds of thousands of ringgit. It is hoped that this expenditure will pare down once the long-term facilities have been set up.